But the first one would be, so my first question is, what we did today after hearing the video, did you recognize it, if you cross it over with other dances you've done? I felt you were very comfortable in the warm-up. You know, it was recognizable. So just give me your thoughts in what things you recognize that you've done before and what things maybe your body, you did that were new for your body. Anybody?
The isolation part reminded me of jazz class as a kid. Yeah. but the coordination of that was very brand new to me. Of the shoulder and the rib and the thin elbow and the, yeah, that was new.
Anyone else? I like to hear your voices.
the hip movement was quite new to me. I feel like, because I've done ballet and contemporary in the past, but I feel like there wasn't so much, not much of my training was so much focused on like the kind of figure eight movement in the hips. And like doing the warm up and going into like the steps felt like it helped to like really warm it up, because I rarely feel warmed up properly in my hips, and that did it.
Oh.
Yeah.
Whenever move the hips like that, I'm
yeah,
exactly.
Like it's always so tight.
So tight, yeah. Anyone else? Any experience you want to share?
I think for me, that movements were very similar to like Roomba. Yeah, because we did a lot of like figure eights and also the breaking it down to the corner and then back. Yeah,
I saw you. Right. Yeah. What about when you started doing the basic step in terms of timing? Did you know where to start, or did you get a bit confused about where to step first when you were left alone?
Yeah, I got a bit confused, I think, when, like, when I had to do it myself. And then, or it was funny when I was doing it myself, but then when I had to lead someone else, that became really complicated because I wasn't just thinking about my own body, I was also thinking about having to guide someone else. And then I think that got
How did you feel that they didn't follow it? Any thoughts?
I think once I was actually leading, the Cuban motion made so much more sense, because if you're pulling someone's rib cage, and that's why like you initiate it from above instead of like down to up. So picturing like someone else's hand like pulling my back kind of made it click a bit more.
Good. Anyone else?
Yeah, I thought the train was really useful to really feel the movement of the ribcage. It's like even if I've done this before, it's still like you feel it a lot more. You understand it better. Mm-hmm.
Jay, as a musician, then that's it.
I agree with train. That was the best thing to help me sort of realize what part of my body was supposed to go where. It was all very new to me.
Cool. Anything else you thought that you want to share?
I did feel like the movement of the rib cage was like reminded me of hip hop and like them walking and like isolations.
Yeah, it is where it comes from, you know, it all comes from the same place. Because a lot of jazz dancers, like I was a jazz dancer before a salsa dancer, so we all started doing body movement like over 20 years ago. The leading is quite interesting because in Latin cultures, like if you go to New York or Puerto Rico, the guys physically move you. So it's not something you have to learn so much because it just happens naturally and everybody has that groove. But if the guy doesn't move you, it's more difficult to give the given motion. However, in my experience, if the girl has groove, the guy relaxes. Like in cultures that are not Latin, like they think they have to speak a lot, and if the girl starts doing the music and moving, the guy will connect more. Because it's ultimately about connecting with your partner, isn't it? Good. So what we're going to do now, like back to front, we're going back to the last one. So I'm going to explain. Who doesn't have? Alex? Maria, you don't have, no? Okay, so I'm going to give you two. You have? No. So I didn't, I mean, you put them back anyway. I don't know if you want to have a calendar. You do. There you go.